So Oliver Anthony made it to the Joe Rogan podcast.
Go Joe, go Joe.
Or go Oliver, go Oliver. And that's not his real name. So his name is Christopher Anthony Lunsford. But he goes, and he said—
You did some deeper research.
I watched the interview. I watched the 2 hour and some change interview. So it was a really long interview. So that's not his actual name. Someone actually said that in one of the comments, but he did confirm it. That's his grandpa's name, and Oliver Anthony. It's like, it's just Oliver Anthony Music. And it's not, he doesn't technically consider it his stage name, but that's what he's gonna go by from now on. But anyways, I do wanna talk about one of my favorite parts of the interview, which is where he talks about God. That's what I wanted us to check out real quick. Or I wanted you to listen to it. To give some context, he had a brain injury, and his brain injury took place at work, but that was one of the biggest causes for the depression that he fell into. So that's what led Joe Rogan to talk about or ask about his eating habits. Because what you eat is very important for your mental health as well.
Right.
Have you tried adjusting your diet?
Well, I'm good now. That's what's so funny. Like, since this has all happened, haven't had a, like, I'm telling you again.
Because you're on top of the world.
Well, yeah, but even before, like, I have to be careful with what I say, because I don't, like, my shit stinks. Like, I'm nobody special, and I'm not here to preach to anybody, but I'm telling you, like, giving things to God, for me.
Right there. Mm-hmm. Giving things to God. I just think that statement is so important and so powerful, because it can apply to almost anything in life, but what you're going through, good or bad. And a lot of times, even when I'm personally going through something, like, stress myself out or become down, and then really when I just get quiet and I make the decision, like, you know what, I can't stress over something I have absolutely no control over, and I just surrender and I just give it to God, it's like, mm-hmm, I just find this peace. Mm. When you learn to let go and let God. So I appreciate him saying that or making it a point to say that.
Mm-hmm. No, it's very important. Prayer. Pray and just let it do what it's gonna do. Have faith within your prayer and within God, and know that everything will get better, and through him all things are possible.
Yeah. You don't have to be a religious person either.
I know for myself, for sure, it's been moments where I didn't know what was going on, and prayer definitely led me down the right path to be in a better place and a better space. So I'm happy that he speaks on God, especially as an artist, and that he mentions it in his music and in his lyrics. And like he said, he said his shit stank.
Right, he's not perfect. He's no one special.
Ain't perfect, nobody special.
None of us.
None of us are. That's amazing.
Yeah. I'd been in church growing up, and I'd been exposed to all of that, but I'd found a lot of theatrics and a lot of politics in church and in religion when I was younger, and so it just immediately turned me off to it.
So if you can, take us to, like, what was, like, the day you picked?
Yeah.
A lot of theatrics and politics in church, mm-hmm, when he was younger, and it turned him off. I think we can all relate to that for sure.
Like, what did you do?
I just changed my perspective.
You change,
I quit, like, worrying about me, and I started worrying about what it is that I'm supposed to do. You know, like, it talks in the Bible about being a servant, and, you know, giving up, I guess, my desire and my will and whatever it is that I want to do. Like, I don't know the best way to describe it, but it's about trying to use what I have as a tool versus doing what I can in the moment to give myself whatever satisfaction that it is I'm trying to get, you know? It's about letting, trying to let go of your ego, I guess, in a way.
I think our ego is probably, if not the biggest, one of our biggest enemies.
Yeah, for sure.
Could be the main thing that sets us back or holds us back is when we serve our ego. And I love
that. Instead of serving God.
Yep.
God.
And I love how he talks about putting the ego aside and no longer serving the ego and reaching for a higher purpose or serving a higher purpose, which is God. When you learn to serve God, by serving God, you are serving others.
We all are here, all on this earth, the purpose, and we're here to serve that. You know what I just thought about? What's the name of that movie again? Soul?
Oh, yeah, the Pixar.
Yeah, that's like one of the best movies.
Oh, yeah.
You guys haven't seen Soul, go watch Soul.
It is a really good movie.
Yeah, it's a Pixar animated. It's lit, though. Maybe. If you have seen Soul, comment in the comments.
Oh, yeah.
Tell people about it. It's great.
It is.
But I think inherently all human beings idolize something. Like it talks in the Bible about false idols. We all have false idols, like whether it's our phone or it's a celebrity or it's something we do or it's our addiction to food or drugs or whatever, but like it's very
false idols. Talking about false idols in today's world, I think people are idling themselves on what they want. Like the word narcissism gets thrown around a lot, and that's really because people are putting themselves first. There's so many people idolizing their own, their emotions, what they want, their feelings. Like, it's all about me, me, me. And I'm like, dude, that's why we're in this chaos that we're in, because a lot of self-worship, false idols. Like, we would more concerned with serving God. I don't think we'd have as many issues that we are having now.
Yeah.
And I think for me, it was just about taking everything else, all the distractions and all the other things in my life away and just ensuring that at least, and look, I'm
my bad. Distractions. I think we're also, we get caught up with distractions.
Beyond distracted. Yes. In today's world, it's
especially like, social media.
It's everything is there to distract you.
Yes.
It's bad.
It's hard not to be distracted. It's hard not to get distracted.
Right.
And I'll be very brief with this, I promise. But like one thing, ironically, it's Proverbs 4:20, which I thought you would like. So if there's anything better.
Perfect.
But,
read it. Preach.
My son, pay attention to what I say. Turn your ear to my words. Do not let them out of your sight. Keep them within your heart. For they are life to those who find them and health to one's whole body. Above all else, guard your heart, for everything you do flows from it. Keep your mouth free from perversity. Keep corrupt talk far from your lips. Let your eyes look straight ahead. Fix your gaze directly before you. Give careful thought to the paths for your feet and be steadfast in all your ways. Do not turn to the right or the left. Keep your foot from evil. But
that's pretty fucking profound.
But the whole book of Proverbs is like that. Like it's not preachy. It's not what you think. Like it's good guidance. It's like good guidance that you would want a father to give to his son.
God brought us Oliver Anthony, and Oliver Anthony is bringing us all together. We need to read the Bible.
Yeah,
and Proverbs.
I'm going to read some Proverbs. You trying to read some Proverbs? Okay, let's do it.